I'm just going up to my office, Barty. Gotta check over some files.
Take the elevator. First door on the right when you come out. You know the way, Kelso.
Harry thinks he could get fresh whenever he pleases.
So, Curtis, what is it you don't want me to see? 34 degrees, 4 minutes, 29 seconds north. 118 degrees, 17 minutes, 58 seconds west. Insured replacement value for the house is $900. Current value of the house and land is $3,500. Christ, how many of these dumps are we carrying on the books?
I have a Detective Phelps of the LAPD here to see you.
Have a seat, Cole. Where's the go-between? She's awful easy on the eye for a foreign girl.
Does that private dick patter actually work on anyone, Kelso? It's not your style. You were always a little more direct.
This is your dime, officer.
Would you have helped me if I asked, Jack? A little chuck on the shoulder, shot of Semper Fi.
Fuck you, Cole. Be a man. Why send a woman to do your dirty work? You're a cop. Why do you want my help?
I thought a PI might be a little more discreet.
I'm no gumshoe. I used to be an investigator for this company before your investigation got me fired.
I'm sorry to hear that, Jack. I'm sorry about a lot of things.
Is that an apology, Cole?
It's a feeble attempted one, yes. Look, Jack, it's a murder case and I need help to solve it.
So what's it got to do with Elysian Fields developments?
I ran it somehow. The flyers keep turning up whenever I find a domestic fire.
They're boosters. Stiffing GIs for deposits, making them wait months for a throw-up house. They're already making more money than they can count. What's turned them into killers?
So you believe me?
This is why you dragged me into the Buckwalter case.
Look, Jack, I'm sorry. But if not for me, do it for some of the poor saps who are dying. Or some of the leathernecks who are getting grifted. How about it, Jack?
I know you, Cole. You're still beating yourself up over that medal on Sugarloaf. The medal you think you didn't deserve, but you just don't get it. Nobody deserves a medal. It's just the ridiculous situation you find yourself in and how you react to it. You think you failed up on that hill. But courage isn't a tap you can turn on or off. Courage isn't permanent. It's a tenuous and fickle thing. Courage and cowardice exist in every man. Get over it.
You got it off your chest.
I guess I have.
Can you help me, Jack?
I'm thinking about it. The Hall of Records is the place to start.
Hello there.
You need some help there, sir?
The Land Registry Office. Where is it?
Just up the stairs.
Thanks. I'd like to see the company details of the Suburban Redevelopment Fund.
Certainly, sir. Just this way.
All those suburban sons of bitches ought to be listed in here. Courtney, for God's sake, what's he got to do with this? I'd like information on a plot of land.
Okay, do you have the address?
Not exactly. It's a new lot. I have the coordinates. 34 degrees, 4 minutes, 29 seconds north. 118 degrees, 17 minutes, 58 seconds west.
All right, that makes it a bit more difficult. Come with me. I believe that is in the Wilshire area, here.
Thirty-four degrees, 4 minutes, 29 seconds north. 118 degrees, 17 minutes, 58 seconds west. It was 34.4.29 latitude, and I'm looking for 118.17.58 on the longitudinal axis. The lot number's 1876988.
Unfortunately, that is just the beginning. We have at least a million lot numbers in the Los Angeles area. The registrations are in alphabetical order. You need to convert your lot number to a letter.
How do I do that?
Over here. Use this adding machine. There are 90,000 entries to a book, so divide your lot number by 90,000.
1876988. Divided by
90,000, yes.
1,876,988 divided by 90,000.
90,000, yes.
20.
A starts at 0, so you want to add 1 to your number.
21.
That number is your letter of the alphabet. Once you have the letter, find the right aisle. You are in business.
You do this every day? Let's see what the site is worth to them. $1,876,988. The book value is $350. With the new home in place, the improved value of the property is $3,500. They can make a killing. But how do they pull it off?
Know why I plumbed for the caddy? The extra trunk space.
One thing you learn in the war, boys. You do your talking once the smoke clears. The guns! Weapon hands on the ground, now! Christ, just missed. I need a word, Courtney.
That's okay, Jack. You didn't need to come all the way down.
It's important, Courtney.
How can I help?
Tell me about the Suburban Redevelopment Fund.
What are you talking about?
Don't fuck with me, Courtney!
Jack, I swear, I don't know what you're talking about.
How does your name appear as one of the investors in the Suburban Redevelopment Fund?
You're out of your mind.
I was down at the Hall of Records checking on a property company called Elysian Fields Developments. Their funding comes from the Suburban Redevelopment Fund.
Seriously, Jack, I have no idea.
Your name is there, Courtney, with some pretty interesting company. The mayor, the district attorney, some dirty cops, and your buddy, Dr. Harlan Fontaine.
Dr. Fontaine?
Spill it, Courtney. I want all of it. Fontaine and the rest.
Fontaine took the morphine off our hands. Look, Jack, I know you said to get rid of it, but it's okay. I did something good for once. He reinvested the money for us. That's it. That's what's happening. They're building houses for GIs, Jack. I turned a mistake into something beneficial, something that's gonna help out the guys.
Courtney, they're building matchstick houses. They're going to burn them for the insurance money. They'll probably stiff the poor bastards for the deposits.
Please, Jack, say it isn't so. Harlan's a doctor, a good one. He helps out a lot of people.
Looks like he's helping himself, Courtney. You're the fall guy. Who's asking?
Leland Monroe.
I was wondering when you'd get around to calling.
I'd like to meet with you, Mr. Kelso.
I bet you would, Mr. Monroe. But I value my skin highly enough to not want to meet with you. Why don't you just send some more of your boys around and we'll have a nice cup of tea?
You realize that I could make you a very wealthy man, Mr. Kelso.
Better than $220 a month? I'm going to have to let it slide, Mr. Monroe.
Are you haggling with me, Jack?
I might be.
Come around to my place at 9. 5164 Santa Monica Boulevard. You'll come?
I might. Good night, Mr. Monroe. I appreciate the help, all of you. We can reminisce later. I want a minimum of noise and no prisoners.
No prisoners? This isn't Pele Lu, Jack.
These guys are grifting GIs. That's what they do for a living.
It's okay, Jack. We all feel the same way. Just hasn't turned out quite the way we imagined.
Let's get it done. Teams of two at the ready.
Throw out the gun!
Want me? You got me.
Was more enchanted by your
love. That's it. Out of ammo. Keep your head down.
After waiting so long for the right time. After reaching so
long. How long do you think you can hold out?
Eyes open. He's around
here.
As soon as he pulls his head out, we step on it.
There's two of them on your right.
I'm gonna find you. Real clever asshole. Real clever asshole. I'm gonna find you.
All right, man, hold the perimeter. I got personal business with Mr. Leland Monroe.
There he is!
Keep on going, Jack. Very sweet-looking girl to be holding such a big gun.
I know how to use it, mister.
I'm sure you do. So how about pointing it over there in the direction of Hollywood instead of at me, princess?
You're quite the wise guy.
I don't normally shoot women, princess. How about putting the cannon down? I didn't think you had the guts, sweetheart. I was never very good at reading women. Monroe! Where are you, damn it?